Hi guys, how are you? Welcome back to Metro Mom, and today onwards I'm starting a new series wherein I'll be attempting some viral DIYs on Pinterest, and I am really excited for this particular series and I hope you guys will also enjoy this video. And after watching this video, please do let me know if you would like to see more video in this series. There is a lot of interesting videos lined up, so please don't forget to hit the bell icon and subscribe to our channel if you have not done it already. But before jumping in the video, I'll quickly talk about sponsor of this video. Mama Earth is sponsor of this video and I want to quickly thank them for supporting us.
Mama Earth is an Indian brand and all of their products are 100% chemical free and completely natural. They are suitable for all skin types and this is why I love using all of their products for my family. If you are someone like me who has been dealing with frizzy hairs, dandruff and itchy scalp, especially during winters, then I think you will love this tea tree mask from Mama Earth. This tea tree hair mask from Mama Earth contains argan, lemon oil and tea tree, and it helps in nourishing the hairs. Before applying the mask, I wet my hair with some water and then I take a generous amount of hair mask and then I apply it over the scalp on my hair roots, and then I leave it at least for 2 hours before the wash. This mask has helped me a lot in controlling my dandruff issue. Every time you order from Mama Earth, they will link your order on the website to a tree that they plant. The exact geolocation, picture and the species of the tree will be sent to you. So do try this mask if you are also dealing with dandruff and itchy scalp. Okay, let's start with our first DIY, which is wooden beads garland. If you love farmhouse or boho style, then you must have spotted this garland all over internet. Either it is Pinterest or Instagram, this garland is everywhere. People are using it for styling their center tables or as curtain tie bags, and there are several other ways in which this garland is being used, and I absolutely love how it looks. This DIY is super simple and it will hardly take 15 minutes. So in order to begin, first we are going to make 2 tassels for the garland, and I am using a fluffy white wool. You can even use jute rope or macrame rope. It is up to you how you want the tassel to look. So I wanted a fluffier looking tassel, so I am using this thick wool, and I am wrapping it around a coaster 12 to 15 times. You can also do accordingly. Once you are done wrapping, then you have to simply tie the open ends, and so that you can easily take out this tassel from the coaster. Then cut it from the bottom and it will start looking like a tassel. Next, you have to take a small piece of the wool and tie the upper section so that it looks like a proper tassel, and then you have to simply trim the end so that it looks cleaner, and just like that our tassel is ready. Now I am going to use 3 style of beads here. It's totally up to you how you want your garland to look. You can use just 1 style of beads or you can mix multiple style of beads. It's totally up to you. I bought all these beads from local shop, and now I am going to put them in a rope. I'm using a thin jute twine. This is also available at local markets. It's very cheap, so you can easily get it anywhere around you. And now I am starting to put the beads in. I have started with a bigger bead because I want my garland to end with the bigger bead, and this is how it looks. While making the garland, make sure that you are following some kind of symmetry so that it looks nicer. And once we are done with the beads, we have to simply tie the tassels at the end, and just like that our beads garland is ready. I love how chic and modern they look, and these days everything related to wood and nature is in trend, so I think this is also a perfect addition to your home if you want to adopt some new styles in your home. And you can style them in numerous ways. You can wrap them around a bottle, keep them on your books, even use them as a tie bags for your curtain. There are 1000 ways of styling these beads garland, and I think you can easily recreate them. Now moving on to our second DIY, which is DIY terracotta look, and this is literally the most viral DIY on Pinterest last year and this year as well. As of now, I have literally seen thousands of videos doing this DIY look. So we are also going to do it. This is very simple and very unique way of giving a textured terracotta look to any of your old ceramic or glass bottles, vases or bowls, anything you can go ahead with. So I'm going to use this old vase of mine. This is chipped from the bottom. Also, I do not like the look of this vase. I bought it from a thrift store for $100, but I am not very happy with how it looks. So I am going to use this brown color, and then I'm going to mix some baking soda into this. Baking soda will give it that textured terracotta look. So I'm using a brown acrylic color here, and I'm mixing baking soda. I'll keep mixing little bit, and then I will check if I like the consistency, and then I'll add more. So in a short while we'll have the desired texture, and then we'll start painting. Just make sure you are not having too watery or too thick of this paste, otherwise you won't be able to do this DIY. So you have to get a medium consistency of this mixture, and then we will start painting the jar. First look is obviously not going to look very great, so we'll have another coat of this mixture, and second time I'm going to make it a little bit lighter. I'm basically mixing a little bit of white color into the brown paint, and this is how it looks after the second coat. I think it looks very nice now, like a proper terracotta vase, and this is how it looks after drying. I really had fun doing this DIY, and I think I know why it got viral. It is so easy to do, and it is such a fun way to transform your old ceramics, even glass bottles and all, and see how the texture looks now. It is looking just like a regular terracotta vase. You can mix different acrylic colors into baking soda and have fun with old ceramics. Now I'm going to attempt the third viral DIY, which is burlap wall art. I have seen burlap all over Pinterest and Instagram, whether it is banners, hoop art, wall art, they are being used everywhere, and I do love their rustic and vintage feel. So I'm also going to attempt one in my own style using things available in India. So to begin with, I am going to use this old wooden frame, and I am going to sand it so that it gets ready for the painting job. And then I will apply two coats of chalk paint on this. Now we are going to use this burlap fabric in this wall art. This fabric can be bought online as well. This is available on Amazon, and I have bought it locally, and I have cut it according to the size of my wall frame. I have cut it roughly, and now I am going to use this felt sheet for cutting out some letters. This felt sheet was bought from Itsy Bitsy. You can buy it from any local stationery shop, and I have taken a printout. I want the alphabets to be in this style, so basically I'm going to trace these alphabets on the felt sheet, and then I will simply cut them out. So I want the wall art to say home, so that is why I have cut four letters accordingly, and now I am placing them on the burlap sheet, and then I will adjust them so that I stick them at proper position. And now I'm going to use some white glue. You can use any glue for sticking these felt alphabets on the burlap sheet. Once we are done sticking the alphabets, then we will stick the burlap fabric onto the wall frame. Now I'm going to use some dried flowers here. I got this flower sometime back. I don't remember the name actually, but you can use any dried leaves or flowers, anything you like. I have air dried them, and now I'm going to stick them onto the frame. I'll use a synthetic glue here to stick them, because Fevicol won't be able to hold these flowers onto the frame. So I'm using this synthetic glue. And using this glue, I'm going to simply stick these dried flowers onto the frame. And here you go, our very own rustic and vintage style home sign is ready, and it was very simple to make. You can even play with the alphabets and make different ones for your, maybe for your dining area. It can say eat or welcome, anything you want, and you can even hang this at your home's entryway. There are a thousand ways of styling it, and I really loved it how it is looking after adding the flowers and all. Moving on to our fourth DIY, which is Hamsa canvas wall art. Hamsa sign came from Middle East, and it is believed that it brings good fortune. I have seen stencils and wall art, tapestry. There are, you know, thousand designs using Hamsa. So we are also going to make one. I am going to use one of my old canvas frame for this. Basically, I'm going to give it a coat of black acrylic paint. You can use a fresh canvas, it is up to you. I wanted to reuse this old canvas, so I'm painting it black. So using a light pencil, I have roughly drawn the Hamsa palm onto my canvas, and now I'm going to use some white paint. I wanted a rough, a chalky look on this canvas, so I am using a watercolor instead of white acrylic paint. I do not want it perfect line, so I am using white watercolor. You can use normal acrylic color and thinner brush, it is up to you. I wanted a rustic look. So once I am done making the outline, then I'll move on to making it a little bit more beautiful, more boho. Now while painting inside this palm, it is completely up to you what kind of design do you want to make inside. You can even make mehndi designs inside this palm. It will look very cool. So you have got complete creative freedom while making this Hamsa palm. I also did some experiment, tried different designs. Whatever attracted me, I painted that. And at any point, if I didn't like the design, then I simply painted it black again, that particular section, and I repainted it. So that way, it was quite an easy DIY to do, and I had a lot of fun making this palm wall art. And this is how the Hamsa wall art has finally turned out. I think it looks really nice. It gives that boho feel to any dull corner. You can even hang it on your wall if you want to have a boho gallery wall. It's totally up to you. You can try different colors, different designs. There are various options you can go ahead with. And I hope you guys enjoyed this DIY. And now it's time to move on to next DIY, which is DIY Pampas Grass. Pampas grass is another viral trend that has taken over Pinterest and Instagram. Pampas grass is not easily available everywhere, so people are DIYing it as well. I have seen a lot of these jute pampas grass, so I am also going to make one today. So for that, I am going to use a stick from my old broom, and now I have cut two equal size of jute rope. So basically, we are trying to do a box knot here. We are using two equal size of twines, and then we will do a box knot. So you have to keep repeating this process until you reach to the top of the broom so that you have a proper looking pampas grass. So as you can see here, I have done a bit of box knots, and I've reached to the mid of the broom, and I will keep repeating till I get till I completely cover the broomstick. So now we are done here, and now we have to unravel these jute ropes, and this is how it will look post brushing and cutting. So this is how the final pampas grass is going to look. Once you are done making the box knot, you have to simply unravel the jute ropes, then you have to brush it and then cut it in a shape of a pampas grass. You can spray some hairspray on these jute pampas grass if you want them to retain their shape. It is a hack both for real pampas grass and for artificial pampas grass which you can always use. This is how the jute rope looks after unraveling. Now after this, you have to simply trim it using a scissor and you can give it a shape of a leaf and you will be done. You can even use some glue stick on the back if you want to secure the knots from falling off. So this is how it looks post brushing. And now I have to simply trim it. And just like that, we are done. You can combine these pampas grass with some dried flowers. This is a huge trend these days, using dried leaves, flowers in your home decor. So this will also give an interesting touch to your dried flower bouquet. Now we have reached to the last DIY of this video, which is tribal art. Tribal art is very popular these days. I have seen them on baskets, on hoops, on wall frames. So I am going to do one using things which I have available with me. So basically I am going to use a bamboo mat which I got from my Assam trip recently. This is used as a floor mat there. So I am going to cut it in two pieces because I want to make a small wall art. So first I am going to paint the midsection with some white acrylic paint or maybe chalk paint, it is up to you. You can use any paint. So I am going to cover the middle section with the white paint. Once done painting the middle section, then I will make a green border around the white section. And then I will cover the rest of the portion with black acrylic paint. Now I am going to paint brown over the green section in order to get an interesting look. I want the green color to peep from behind. This is completely optional. It's up to you. If you don't like this, you can skip this step. Now I am just making black lines in the alternate section of the white area. And in the end, I am simply going to paint diamond section in alternate rows, and then I will cover the rest of the area with brown paint. And this is how the final wall art looks now. I have used a bigger frame for this wall art as of now. I will get a proper frame for it. But I think it looks interesting. It gives a nice vibe to your guest room or any corner of your home. And I hope you guys enjoy this video and all the other 5 DIYs which I have done today. And if you like this series, if you want to watch more video in this series, then do let me know. And I will see you soon next week.